Hello children, in this video we are going to see creating buttons in Expression Web 4. Children, Microsoft Expression Web 4 has provided advanced graphical buttons and has made it easier for you to add buttons to your web pages. Okay, now we can see the steps for creating buttons. First you can go to menu bar, click on the insert menu. Here you can choose the interactive button. Okay, now the interactive button dialog box will be displayed. Here scroll down and choose the glass tab 3 button style. Okay, this one is the glass tab 3. Okay, the interactive button dialog box lets you add and set certain properties for the button. There are three tabs in the interactive button dialog box that allow you to set properties for the buttons. First one is the button tab. The button tab has four sections, namely preview, buttons, text and link. Preview. It shows a preview of a button that has been selected in the button list given below. Next one, buttons. It shows the list of available buttons to choose an appropriate button for your page. Next one, text. It is the text box where you have typed the text that should be displayed on the button. Next one, link. Link is the text box to type or browse the hyperlink location for the button. This link could be a link to another page in the current website or to another website or to create an email address. Next one, font tab. The font tab lets you see buttons, text and font properties. Here font, font style and size specifies the font face, style and size. First one, original font color. Original font color is the text color. Next one, hovered font color. It specifies the color of the text when the mouse pointer is hovered over it. Third one, pressed font color. It specifies the text color when the button is pressed. Okay, the next one, image. Sorry, one more thing is there, horizontal alignment and the vertical alignment. Here it specifies the alignment of the text. Okay, next one, image. Image tab. This tab specifies the image dimension options like width and height and maintain properties. First one, create hover image. This checkbox, when checked, it changes the appearance of the button over the mouse hover. Second one, create pressed image. This checkbox, when checked, changes the button when clicked. Next, preload button images. This checkbox, when checked, it loads all the button images in the memory. Next, if you choose make the button as JPG image and use this background color to set the solid background color. Yes, you can choose make a button GIF image and use a transparent background. This is used to set the transparent background. Okay. Then last, click OK when you are done and the button would be placed on your page. Now, I am choosing this one. Here I will type home. For example, I am typing the button name as home. Here you can see the preview. Okay, if you change the button style also, you can change it from here. Now I am choosing this one. Okay, when the home button is placed on your page, you can cut, copy and move the button wherever you want inside the page even after placing the button. Okay, before that I gave button text, so that button is also present here. Next I gave home button, so it is placed here. Okay, after you finishing everything, you can save your file. If you want to add more pages in the site and create buttons to navigate all the pages, create buttons like next page, previous page, home button is already created for you here, right? So you can continue with the file and complete it. The saved files are stored in the my website folder. Okay, so that's all about today's video, children. Thank you.